Do you have a passion for music? Yes? Sweet.
Are you sure?
Yes?
You sure?
Okay, cool. That's good. Now, are you interested in studying music in college? Yes, kind of, sort of, maybe? Well, if the answer is any of those, then that's where I come in. Whenever I started music school 4 years ago, I was pretty excited, but also I had no clue what I was getting myself into. No one in my family prior to me had ever studied music in college, and apart from like a couple other things that I heard just in band about like what music school is like, I really didn't know what it was like. I thought it would have been really cool to make a video where I explain to people who are interested in pursuing a degree in music what it's like on the day-to-day basis of a music major and my advice to anyone who wants to do it, just because I didn't have this information when I started and I really wish I had some of it, at least some, just because I went into it not knowing anything and I suffered a little bit because of it. So I think it'd be really nice to just give that information to who really needs it before they just go into it blindly like I did. Now, I'm going to be talking about stuff that kind of happened to me personally and the school that I went to. Every school is a little different, but a lot of them kind of do stuff similarly, so hopefully you'll get some tips and tricks from this, like, no matter where you go. So, what happens in the life of a music major? Well, biggest thing is a lot of practicing, and I mean a lot of practicing. And if you think that you're not going to be doing a lot of practicing, then you're wrong. If you want to be successful, you have to practice. Every musician knows this, but it's definitely true in college, and especially if you're going from maybe a smaller school or you're used to not practicing that much and just getting by, and you go to music school and try to like really hit it home, then you are going to be practicing a lot. Especially speaking as a percussionist, there's a lot of instruments that you need to learn if you want to be a successful percussionist. And I mean, it's important, but also it's hard. I'm going to say it's hard because you have to do a bunch of practicing on top of your other obligations. Speaking of obligations, you're going to be taking a lot of classes. Now, a normal music major schedule, that's usually like 15 to 18 hours. The thing is, a lot of music majors have to deal with the thing where a lot of their main music classes are either 2, 1, or 0 credit hours. But here's the kicker. They're all required to graduate. So that could mean that you're taking up to like 7, 8, 9, or 10 classes in a single semester, especially in like the first couple of years. And that can add up, especially when you have all this homework in your regular classes and also practicing. It can be pretty challenging to juggle all these different classes at once, even though certain ones may not be actual classes. Technically, they don't have to be classes, but they still cause work for you. Like, one class I was in was recital attendance, and I had to go to a class every other week where it was just a guest speaker, but the actual main point of the class is that I had to go to recitals, like, throughout the semester and get credit through that. And if I didn't do, like, a certain amount, I think it was 15, then I failed the class. It was, like, pass-fail thing. So, yeah, that can be a little challenging. So on top of all the homework and practicing and multiple classes you need to juggle, you also have concerts. That's kind of an important part of being a musician, the concerts. When you're practicing for all the ensembles and groups you're in, but you're also practicing for lessons, so there's a lot of different things to be spreading your time with just with practicing. And also, you have juries at the end of each semester, and when I say jury, I don't mean like in a courthouse, we're not talking about Judge Judy or anything. A jury is essentially a musical final. You prepare either a few pieces or some excerpts or whatever you've been doing in lessons, and you perform it at the end of the semester for either your professor or a panel of people, including your professor and a couple other faculty members, and you get graded from that. This sort of thing kind of gets you ready for when you have to do recitals in the future, but if you're just starting out, don't worry about it. That's something you'll come across way later. So there's a lot of daunting things you have to handle while being a music major, but one really cool thing about it is that you're surrounded by people that love to make music, and they're just there to express themselves. Mostly. There are some people that aren't really into it, and it shows through their performance and their mannerisms, and they kind of just quit. But other than those jokers, everyone else is there to just make music, and it's such a fun thing to be around. Hopefully I gave a decent explanation of what it's kind of like. There's a lot of work that's involved with it, but also that's every major in college. That's like everything you do whenever you study something in college. It's a lot of work, but if you're really passionate about it, you'll find something that you really like and you'll stick to it. And with the people that you meet along the way, it's very, very rewarding and it's an experience that you'll never forget. So my advice when it comes to starting out music school, I think the biggest thing I want to say right off the bat is make connections. I cannot stress this enough. Make connections, make friends, make connections that last for a long time. Now, a lot of people make friends in college. A lot of people make friendships that last a very long time. In music school, it's really important to, one, make connections, make friends, whatever you call it. But two, it's really important to make good connections. And by what I mean is you don't want to be a jerk to your friends, your colleagues, your professors and stuff, because it could come back and bite you in the butt. Because if you have a future gig opportunity, you have an opportunity to play for someone really big or something, maybe someone that you met in college could help you out with that. Or someone you met like through college, but it's like outside of college, can help you out with that. Like, it doesn't have to be in college per se, but it's like, trust me, connections are really important. They can really help you just like get started when you get out of college. And also just making really good connections with really good friends. Say yes to any opportunity that comes your way. Now, and that may sound annoying, you may be thinking, well, I don't want to do everything in college. You were just talking about how you have to do a lot. Yes, you do have to do a lot, but whenever you do have the chance to say, yes, I can do something, or I can play in this one recital, or play for this one random gig outside of class, do it. Because you never know, one, whether you'll like whatever you're doing and want to do it more in the future, whether that be out of class, out of college, whatever. And you don't know who you'll really meet through those gigs. So I think just whenever you have our opportunity to do more of that stuff, just do more of that stuff. Here's a really important one. Know when to ask for help. This is something I struggled with when I was in college. I don't know why, but I just like to just do everything myself. I think my YouTube channel kind of proves that. I just do everything myself. And whenever I'm just trying to get through something, I tend to just kind of go throughout it my way. And being a little stubborn, like, I didn't know really when to ask for help. And especially when things are really tough, things are getting you down. Like, if you have, like, a connection and you have friends, you have a little circle that you can come to, or I guess go to, then it's really important to say, hey, I need help with either this assignment or with life or just with whatever, because there are people out there that want to help you, that want to help you succeed and help you be happy and stuff. Again, I wish I had done better at that whenever I was younger, but I didn't. So no one asked for help. It's also important to let people know whenever you're struggling with something like imposter syndrome or confidence issues or just whatever is bothering you. I dealt with all that stuff. Literally all that stuff, like pretty much everything. I dealt with it whenever I was doing college. And I didn't really talk about it too much, but except for like one friend. And I probably could have done it more, but I'm just saying it's important to really speak out, especially whenever your mental health isn't really that great. This sort of thing kind of comes from whenever school's kind of tough, you're grinding to get everything done, you're trying to meet all the standards that's been set on you, and it's bit overbearing, and like maybe you're being told stuff that you're not really liking in terms of music, and maybe you're just done, you just don't want to do it anymore. Well, first off, if you need to take a break, I suggest you take a break. I think burnout is a very scary thing whenever you're doing music, because it could just ruin music for you completely. I experienced burnout whenever I was, I don't even know what age, like it was my sophomore year. Like, I was just burned out on percussion. It was only a very, very short time. It was whenever the OKPass festival happened a couple years ago, and I was just done with music, honestly. But due to a couple instances, I was reminded of why I loved music. So it was a very quick turnaround for me. But if you're ever in that situation, just take a sec and just kind of do what you enjoy. Even if that includes not practicing for like a couple days, I just suggest you do it. I've done it a couple times just because I need to clear my head. I just need to get away, because if you do music 24/7, then you're gonna hate it. That's just a simple truth. That's true with anything. So if that ever happens, just know that it's fine. It's natural. Just take a break and it'll be fine. The second thing I'll say about that is it's nice to have a little reminder of why you're pursuing music in the first place. Whether that be a little note you write on a sticky note and put on your door, whether that be a little reminder you have on your phone that you check from time to time whenever you're feeling down, or whether you just think of the time that you got inspired and wanted to pursue music in the first place. Like, it's really good to have just that reason of why you do it. I have a couple reasons that I like to look back to. The first one being this channel, and even though it was kind of cringy at the beginning, just me being so excited about band and loving music and just combining that with my love of making videos is why it really kept going. The other thing I like to think about is how I got to play in the Oklahoma Music Educators Association, or OMEA, my senior year of high school whenever I made Allstate. This was a big deal for me since I had been trying since sophomore year and I finally made it my senior year. And it was such an amazing experience, and it made me realize I wanted to be a music major. And like, that was probably one of the like funnest weekends I ever had, just because I got to make such fun music with such like awesome people. It just reminded me how great it is to perform in a group, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for that instance. This is probably a weird one, but recognize any other talent that you have that's not making music. Whatever talent that is, it can also help you set you apart from the crowd whenever you're trying to do something outside of college. Now, my thing is making videos, if that's not clear, and I got to really explore that in the past 2 years, and I think, honestly, it's very, very important to have that one thing, other than like trying to do something else in the future, just having another creative outlet, because like doing all this, like it helped me not get burnt out on music as quickly as I did, and it helped me kind of refocus on what I really wanted to do. And the last thing is, enjoy it. It's a really fun thing to do, and the fact that you get to do it for 4 years with such a talented group of people and with such great minds, it's something you never get back. And it's a really, really fun experience that you just wish you had forever. If anyone that's watching has had any other experience that they've had that they wish they knew before they did music school, go ahead and put it in the comments, because there's so much stuff that I wish that I knew before starting, and there's a lot of stuff that I don't know, and everyone's experience is different, so maybe there's something that someone else says that I'm like, oh yeah, that makes a lot of sense. But I just really hope to kind of connect with like future music makers out there that really want to make this something special, that just don't have all the information. I really want to provide that information for you, because I didn't, but I want to be the thing that kind of changes that. Okay, that's all I got. Sorry for any weird lighting things that happened during the video. It's very cloudy, and my main source of light is the sun right now, but I'm going to be moving soon, so hopefully that will be less of an issue. Maybe. We'll see. I don't know. But, yeah, that's about it. God bless, and I'll see you next time. Bye.